Hello friends, today in this video we will be talking about the shadow price concept. This term has been continuously used in social cost benefit analysis, UNIDO approach, right? And like as far as I have seen, people, they don't understand the exact meaning of shadow price, what this shadow price is all about. So in this video I will be discussing with you what is the meaning of shadow price and what are the examples of shadow price and what are its advantages and disadvantages, right? So let's start with this. Shadow price, this is also known as shadow pricing. It is the real economic price of projects, activities, goods and services that have no market price. Right now, we in shadow price, we consider those services, we consider those goods which for which the market price is difficult to be estimated. So we try to we try to approximate the price, that what can be the price of this good, right? It is merely based upon the judgment or approximation. It also includes projects, etc., for which prices are difficult to be estimated. Now, this shadow pricing, this is done for the projects also, that when the companies, they have to undertake a project, but they can't estimate the price of that particular project, then they try to approximate the price. They try to approximate this price and they try to establish a trade-off between the price and the benefits which are associated with the project. Now, the shadow price, it is the opportunity cost, that is what somebody had to give up when they had made a choice. Now, we all know that if we want something, we need to compromise one or the other thing. Fine. Now, how much we can compromise and how deadly we need that particular thing, on the basis of that, the price of those goods or services are decided. Now, the shadow price, it means the highest price that a company is willing to pay, that would pay for one extra unit of something, right? Now, if the company, they desire something very badly because that can be of very much benefit for long-term future, then they will be ready to pay any price for that, because the benefit which they can see, that is a long-term benefit. Fine, and for which they think that they can pay that money because they take it as an investment point of view. Shadow pricing, it involves determining whether doing something will bring in greater benefits than the cost incurred. Now, as I said, that it helps you to determine that whatever you want to do in the organization, whatever project you want to undertake in the organization, what benefits it is going to incur in the future. Now, when we have estimated the shadow price, we subsequently decide whether to go ahead with the plan or not. And if we decide to go ahead, how much we are willing to spend on it, right? So this is what is the shadow price concept. They say is that first of all, we try to understand what are the benefits associated with the project and what price we are willing to pay. Right, that price which we are willing to pay is known as the shadow price. And after that, when we undertake the project, how much we can actually spend on that particular project, that we have to decide. Now, over here, let's have an example. Now, you can see here that there are some people sitting on the management table and one person is there. Over here, the management is saying that they want to deliver the goods to the customer early, right? You can see that in green color, we have a delivery person who wishes that the delivery man should deliver the goods or parcel to the customer as early as possible, because that particular customer is very much important for the company, because that customer gives new leads of the customers to the company, right? Now, the company is seeing a long-term business relationship with that particular customer, or you can say that with the help of that particular customer, the company is having the probability to gain more business with new number of customers, right? So for the company, that particular customer is much important, and to maintain a relationship with that particular customer, the company is asking the delivery boy to work overtime to deliver the goods to that particular customer. Right. Now, when we are asking our employees or the delivery boy to work overtime, obviously we have to pay him something for which he will be convinced to work overtime. Fine. And how much we need to pay, or how much the company decides to pay for overtime to the worker, that is known as the shadow price. And the company is saying that management is willing to pay up to rupees $10,000 for early delivery. Now, this is what I have written over here, that a company was considering paying one of its delivery workers overtime to transport a shipment to a customer early. And if it does so, there is a good chance of getting much more business from the customer. Now, the company assigns a shadow price of $10,000. In other words, that is the benefit of having an improved business relationship with the buyer. Therefore, management will pay up to $10,000 to the dispatcher to make the delivery. And this $10,000 is the shadow price of working overtime so that the delivery boy can make an early delivery to the customer. Now you can understand the shadow pricing, where overtime is offered to employees for their extra time so that they can work longer and increase the productivity of the company. We have a company, DPL. This is a transport company which has to make deliveries sometimes at the odd hours to their exclusive customers. This is because these clients give them other clients and it is a mutual beneficial agreement. The company decides a shadow pricing of $2,000 as the benefit it derives from its deal. Hence, they are willing to pay up to $2,000 to the truck driver that makes early deliveries. Now, this was an example similar to the previous one. Now, the other example you can see is that if a company decides to renovate their office building, what will be the benefits associated with that? New building, new office will give a good feeling to the employees also, who are sitting there, who are working there. And obviously, if the environment is good, if the employees are feeling good in the new environment, then the productivity is going to increase because of the changed ambience of the organization. And yes, the companies, they want to increase the productivity, so they will be willing to pay some extra cost so that the productivity of the companies increase. Now, this benefit can be estimated only by the concept of shadow price. Now, what can be the advantages of shadow price? That it is a useful tool which helps to know what are the benefits associated with the extra use of resource, like what is the benefit of making the employee work overtime. It comes in handy when you have to convert resources into social cost. You can convert assumed impacts into social benefits. It is a device that is used for the optimal allocation of resources, and they avoid underpricing. You cannot underestimate the prices of the goods or services, because shadow prices, like companies, they generally overestimate the price because they are seeing their long-term benefits in that particular service. The best part is that it takes into account the opportunity cost. Now, what are the limitations? It is simply a guesswork. It can be wrong also. It is an approximate work. Now, it is based upon the probability. It is not a reliable data, and it is a limited perception because we are considering only a particular situation. Now, it has certain biases attached to it, that they are sample and response. The chance of wrong estimate is high. It is based upon assumptions. This lacks generality. This is very specific in nature. Like, we have talked only about one thing, working overtime. But there are many other scenarios which have to be looked upon while working on this particular scenario. And it is a static notion. It is not a dynamic one, that with the change in situation, the prices are also going to change. No. The shadow pricing fails to reflect social opportunity cost in the long run. Right? So these were the benefits and limitations of social shadow price, right? In this video we discussed about the meaning of shadow price. I hope the meaning was very much clear to you all, and if you like the video, please share this video with other people, your friends. And if you want video on any other topic, you can always mention it in the comment section, and subscribe to the channel Operations Point for more videos related to the subject. Thank you.